Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new here, hi, my name is Valentina. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I created this makeup look by using great makeup products that I really like at the moment. And I have some updates on my last video, so if you like what you see and want to find out more, then keep on watching. Has been a while since I haven't tried this Infallible by L'Oréal Paris, and I want to use it for today's video. I really like the finish of this foundation. I also like that this comes with a pump and it's really easy to use. What I like to do is to pour some on the back of my hand, and I'm going to spread it all over my face, and then I am going to blend it with my beauty blender. I really like how good my skin look up close with this foundation. It has a very pretty finish and it's definitely full coverage, but if you apply every small amount of this and spread it all over your face, you could definitely achieve a more natural looking finish. For my concealer, I'm going to use this Pat McGrath Labs. This is Skin Fetish Sublime in the shade L1. I've used this one for the first time in my last video, so I definitely recommend you to check my last video and see my full opinion of this product. And I have to say that I don't have any bad things to say about this product. I pretty much use it every day. I like the finish of it. I like how it wears throughout the day. And if you set it, it will not budge. So I'm very impressed by this concealer. I could use it to cover my blemishes also. It's full coverage but doesn't look heavy, which is very nice. I've used the excess product on my eyelid and I'm going to leave it this way because I'm not going to apply any eyeshadow primer. So this will be my eyeshadow primer for today's video. I just love the finish of this concealer. Doesn't enhance any fine lines. I definitely recommend you to use this product if you have the chance. I'm going to quickly set everything in place with this Hyaluronic Hydra Powder. I know I use it in every video, but I really like it. Sets everything in place and I don't look dry. Another makeup product that I've used in my last video is this Glowish by Huda Beauty in the shade Light. I can stop wearing this product, I really like it, I like the finish of it. Regarding the shade, I've mentioned that it's a little bit yellow for my skin tone. I quickly fixed this problem with some blush over this and it looks amazing. So I am going to show you how I like to use this product. I've used it since my last video, like every day, so I really like it. So I've got this bronzer on, and what I like to do is to go over with some blush. And I found out this cream blush by Fenty Beauty works just fine over all of these powders. So I like to dip my fingers into this. This is in the shade Strawberry Drip, by the way. I'm And I'll go over with my beauty blender with whatever's left from my foundation and blend everything nice together. So I've been loving this combo, this bronzer with this cream blush. I've said it before that this blush is very good and works just fine over powders, at least on my skin. The secret, I think, is to blend it first with your fingers to not move anything underneath, and after go back with your beauty blender to blend it well into the skin. I recommend you to buy this product, yes, if you have the chance, go get it. It's summer and it's very hot outside, and I really want my makeup to last. So in those days when I really want my makeup to last all day, it really helps to apply this all-nighter setting spray by Urban Decay. This not also that makes my makeup to last all day, but it also make my skin look very nice. So I really like to apply this product after all of my powders and also my cream blush, and before I will move on to my highlighter. So I'm going to quickly spread this all over my face. I also recommend you to go back with your sponge or with your brush, if you like, to really blend this product into the skin. I recently discovered this highlighter by e.l.f. and I've used it since. This baked highlighter by e.l.f. in the shade Moonlight Pearls is very, very pretty. It has that wet finish look that I'm looking for. Not that greasy looking, but you know, that fresh, dewy skin. And I also love that this works very well on my textured skin. So, very, very good and affordable product. This makes me wanna buy more products by e.l.f. because I don't have many, I just have like two products. And I will also use this on my inner corner, so I am going to apply it right now. And I thought that I could use this eyeshadow palette by Huda Beauty, this Mercury Retrograde. I'm going to apply this Karma color all over my eyelid. These shadows are very pigmented and very good quality. So if you want to invest in one eyeshadow and you really like this color theme, from here, this eyeshadow palette definitely worth the money. The shimmers and the metallics in here are just gorgeous. I'm going to apply some on my lower lash line. So I just used this vortex shade closer to my lash line just to define the lash line, and I'm going to take this Nebula shimmer shade and put this all over my eyelid. This is very, very pretty. I'm going in with the same blending brush and blend here a little bit. I'm going to add more of this vortex to intensify the lash line. I think this Nebula shade shimmer is very nice, and I am going to apply it also on my inner corner just to make it more intense. For my mascara, I am going to use again this Pat-McGrath Labs Fetish Eyes Mascara. I used it in my last video and I have to say that I am very impressed by this mascara. I like that it's very easy to use. I like that this is very, very black. and I don't have to spend so much time to do my lashes, which I really like. But I'm very curious how I perform with a lash primer. And I have this Dior Show Maximizer 3D. To really see the difference, I'm going to apply the lash primer just on one eye, and on the other side I'm going to apply just the mascara. So before this will dry up a little bit, I'm going to apply mascara on this eye, and then I'll go back with the mascara also on this eye. The mascara performed well on its own, as you can see on this eye. And I'm going to quickly apply on the side when I have the lash primer. These are my lashes right now. I definitely have more volume in here, but it gets a little bit clumpy with the lash primer. But I have to say that I like it better in here. I think my lashes look very, very nice. So I'm going to quickly apply the mascara on my bottom lashes. It's a little bit hard because this has fluffy bristles, and it's a little bit hard to use it on here. But I will try to do this and be right back. So these are my lashes with this Fetish Eyes mascara by Pat McGrath. I have to say that this is already my favorite mascara. I really like it. So I'm going to quickly do my lips, and I am going to apply this Huda Beauty Lip Contour 2.0 in Rusty Pink all over my lips. And I really want to add some gloss, and I'm going to use this Fenty Beauty Gloss Bomb in the shade Fussy. I like that this makes my lips juicier and big. So that's it for today's video. This is the finished makeup result. I really like how the makeup turned out. I hope that you like it too. All the makeup products used today are very good, and these are my favorites right now. And I am pretty happy with my latest makeup products, which is this Glowish by Huda Beauty, and also Pat McGrath Labs, the mascara, and also the concealer. Please let me know what makeup products would you like me to test next. So that completes this video. I really hope that you like this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And also ring the bell to be notified when I upload. I post every week, so make sure to hit that notification bell. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!